We need to determine the points on the function where the tangent line has a slope of 4. The derivative function does tell us the slope of the tangent lines at a given value of x. So what we can do here is find our derivative function, set it equal to 4, and then solve for x. That'll tell us the x coordinates at where the tangent line has a slope of 4. So f prime of x is going to be equal to 1/3 times the derivative of x cubed, that'll be 3x squared, minus 4 times the derivative of x squared, that's 2x, plus 16 times the derivative of x, which is just 1, so we have 16, plus the derivative of 4, which is 0. So let's go ahead and clean this up, set it equal to 4, and solve for x. So here we'll have x squared minus 8x plus 16. We want to know when this is equal to 4. This will tell us the locations of where the tangent line has a slope of 4. We have a quadratic, so we'll go ahead and subtract 4 on both sides. So we'll have x squared minus 8x, this will be plus 12, equals 0. This is factorable. We want the factors of positive 12 that add to negative 8. That'll be negative 6 and negative 2. So the solutions to this equation are x equals 6 and x equals 2. So again, these are the x coordinates to the points where the tangent line will have a slope of 4. So now to determine the y coordinates of these points, which are points on the function, we need to determine f of 6 and determine f of 2. It's important to remember that these x values go back into the original function, not the derivative function. And to determine these function values, we're going to go ahead and use the graphing calculator. So we're going to enter the original function in y equals. So we'll clear out this old function. We'll type in the new one. Now with the function in y1, we're going to go back to the home screen, and then we'll use function notation to determine these values. So we're going to press vars, right arrow once, enter at function, select y1, and then we can just put in parentheses 6, so when x is 6, y is equal to 28. And we'll do the same for x equals 2. Again, we'll press vars, right arrow once, enter, enter, and then in parentheses, enter 2. This one doesn't come out so nice. 0.6 repeating is equal to 2/3, but if we didn't recognize that, we could press math, enter, enter, and it will convert the decimal to an improper fraction. So let's go ahead and write this down. When x is equal to 6, we had y equals 28. And when x is equal to 2, we have 68/3, or 22 2/3. So this was 28, and this was 22 2/3. The calculator gave us 68/3, which is equivalent to 68 divided by 3. So we have 2, that'd be 6, subtract, bring down the 8. 2, that'd be 6, with a remainder of 2, which does give us the 22 2/3. As a mixed number. So let's check to make sure that these points, we do have a tangent line with a slope of 4. Our first point was 6, 28, that point here, and this point here was 2 2/22 2/3. And notice how at these two points, these two lines are parallel because they both have a slope of 4. I hope this was helpful.